A wise philosopher once pondered, who let the dogs out? Who? 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 Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Dogs come in all sorts of varieties, from tiny Chihuahuas to Great Danes. Dogs are more variable in size, shape, and temperament than any other living mammal. The American Kennel Club recognizes 167 dog breeds, but the world governing body of dog breeds, the FCI, recognizes 340 breeds. Dogs are members of the family Canidae, which is a lineage of carnivorans, which include wolves, foxes, and jackals. Fossils show that Canidae split off from the ancestors of carnivora about 40 million years ago. Despite the wide spectrum of body types, colors, and behaviors, all dogs share a common ancestor. They're all direct descendants of the Canis lupus, or gray wolf. What's unclear is exactly when these wolves became domesticated. At some point, wolves began to linger around humans, who eventually bred them into different forms of dogs. One study published in the journal Current Biology found that modern dog ancestors split from wolf ancestors at least 27,000 years ago. Fossils dating back as far as 36,000 years ago hinted at the transition, with mixed features of both wolf and dog. A May 2013 study in Nature Communications reported that wolves and Chinese indigenous dogs split 32,000 years ago. Researchers used demographic analysis of different mutations in the genomes of dogs and wolves, with the results indicating that dogs initially scavenged with humans. But a recent discovery has experts rethinking dogs' ancestry altogether. According to a study in Scientific Reports, the remains of a supposed dog from over 31,000 years ago were actually those of a wolf. Researchers used 3D imaging to compare the fossil found at Goyet Cave in Belgium to other dogs and wolves. The results found the features to be more wolf than dog, which indicates that dogs did not gradually evolve from wolves over a long period of time. The study says that the domestication of dogs took place during the Neolithic era, when humans started forming settlements and farming around 12,000 years ago. If this is true, it refutes previous research that stated that dogs emerged in the Paleolithic era, when people were hunter-gatherers. So when did dogs become man's best friend? The bones of a puppy and an elderly person were found buried together in Israel, dating back 14,000 years. Even though dogs were domesticated so long ago, most dog breeds were developed within the last few centuries, and some breeds have changed a lot even just in the past 100 years. Ancient humans started to breed dogs for desired features like a louder bark or a calmer demeanor, which effectively meant that they were messing with the selection of dog genes. Over time, the breeds increased due to natural mutations and climate in addition to human preferences. To this day, dogs are still evolving as we continue to create new dog breeds. This is evident in the trend of designer dogs like the Labradoodle and the Puggle. So do you love dogs? Have you always loved dogs? So does Andrew Flatabo, a photographer who tries to capture the precious moments of working pooches. Check out this great episode from This Happened Here.
A unique dog to New Zealand, which is not defined by physical characteristics, but by the job they perform. They excel at moving sheep uphill and in close quarters using their loud bark.
What's your take on how dogs evolved? Do you have a favorite dog breed? Let us know. You can tell us over on Facebook or on Twitter at DNews. I'm there as well at Julia_SCI. Thanks for watching.